The country was already on fire and falling apart. The evil spirits of the past have come to life, and centuries of hatred have continued to spread. I was 14 years old when I first saw Milica. She was beautiful, tall, with thick black hair. Around her stood people with top hats, dressed in black and white uniforms, sprinkled with flavor and powder. They screamed magnificently, loud voices. I couldn't understand anything. That evening, I felt a new self in me. The next day, I read in newspaper that it was Dada Symposium. It was called Before the New Year. It was in the Catholic yard. I decided to become an artist. I went to drawing and painting classes, completely ready to enter the world of art. Milica was my first teacher. After a few months, we founded performing troupe Ex Nihilo, or Out of Nothing. It was at the Jewish cemetery. The life case of the troupe on art scene in the 90s was not recognized by the National Art Society. The unchanging constant of performance were our bodies as organisms, as media, in agony, sexual, political, vulnerable, ecstatic, profane, sacred and mythical. All performances in the first year took place at the Petrovaradin fortress. We were nihilists rejecting the authorities, defended the independence of individual. We were Dadaists, anti-bourgeois, preferring the irrational, denied concept of art, placing it in the context of anti-art. We put a new meaning in our expression with roaring and musical noise. It was a harmonious chaos. We created international journal for production of a new reality called Very Viri. And so that it was it, and it was beautiful. Audience were wondering, horrified, adoring us or spitting at us. Afterwards, we parted. Majority went to Israel, Netherlands, Czech Republic, United Kingdom, Ireland, and Bosnia. Few of us stayed here. The fortress is still there. God is still and around us. We walk from the steps of the fortress into new identities. We are still one body, something like a polyp or amoeba. Through us, God flows even more and gives us the light that illuminates this world.